Shalom. I want to give all praise and glory unto Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Raka Kodash. Double honors goes out to the elder apostles of Great Millstone for teaching me this truth. Also want to acknowledge all the Akian pushing this truth with sincerity, all right? So, the Spirit has me today in 2 Samuel 23. And it's talking about our King David, all right? So it says, "Now these be the last words of David. David, the son of Jesse, said, and the man who was raised up on high, the anointed of the power of Jacob, and the sweetest psalmist of Israel, said," all right? And when you go into that word psalm, it means song. So it says here, "the sweetest psalmist of Israel," you see? I did the research, and King David wrote 73 psalms, all right, which I believe there's 150 psalms, and he wrote 73 of them, all right. So, just a fact that I stumbled across, all right. But anyway, that was one of his titles, the sweetest psalmist of Israel. So, the sweetest songwriter of Israel, you see, because these psalms, that's what they are. They're like songs. They are songs. It's poetry, you see. And our King David, he was known as the sweet psalmist of Israel, as you can see in verse 1. Verse 2, "The Spirit of Yahweh spake by me, and his word was in my tongue." See, and the words that we bring out, as we always speak on, you know, these are not our own words, but the words that are on our tongues are from Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai, all right? And when the Spirit of the Lord is dealing with you, then you're going to be prophesying, all right? Verse 3, "The power Yahweh of Israel said, the Rock of Israel spake to me, he that ruleth over men must be just, ruling in the fear of Yahweh," all right? So, and this is spiritual too. This is one of the clues that through the Spirit we know that Peter was also King David, all right? Because that word rock, it literally means in Spanish is piedra, all right? And Peter, it means rock. So that's one of the clues that shows us through the regeneration, King David was also Peter, the same soul. All right, whether you're able to receive that or not, all right, as the brother, the guard, put in the brother Gar's words, all right, from our camp, he always says that if you can receive it or not, and he's right, you either can receive it or you can't, man. King David and Peter were the same soul, but a Christian or a two-third can never see that or never get that. Verse 4. "And he shall be as the light of the morning when the sun riseth, even a morning without clouds, as the tender grass springeth out of the earth by clear shining after the rain." All right? So light and you know, the grass springing out of the earth, that's all symbolic to you know, life. And what gives us this life is this truth, this word. All right? This is when Yahweh Shai breathed life into the you know, to the apostles, the disciples, hey, he was teaching them this truth, giving them life. That's what we're doing. One third of our people are going to receive life, you know, and not condemnation to the lake of fire, because they're going to hearken and listen to this truth that we're bringing out by the Spirit and power of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. All right? Let's go to Psalm 72 and 6 for a precept. "He shall come down like rain upon the mown grass and showers that water the earth." Alright, you see? So that's what it is, man. We're coming down like rain upon mown grass. You see, giving it life, man. What's that mown grass going to do? The mown grass is a metaphor for the one-third, the people that listen to the prophets, you know, and we're the rain, See? And what are we doing? We're watering the earth. We're giving him this. You know, Yahweh Shai said that you shall never thirst again. Let's get that real quick. Why will you never thirst again? Because the ones who listen to the prophets are going to get knowledge and wisdom, man. Let's see. Oops, that's, I meant to spell that wrong. So like, yeah. There it is, John 4:14. Let's get it. And that's a 1:4:4 verse. So I'll call all Yahweh Bashem Yahushai. This is Yahweh Shai talking, John 4:14. But whosoever drinketh of the water that I shall give him shall never thirst, but the water that I shall give him shall be in him a well, a water of water springing up to everlasting life. Kalal Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai, alright? We're going to get everlasting life because of this truth. It's putting life in our into our bodies, man. You know, Yahweh Shai is breathing life into us. When we study this Bible, when we you know, able to see the breakdowns, the parables, you know, we're never gonna thirst, man. So call out Yahweh Bashem Yahshai once again, man. We're back, but that's that water, man. That we're like the rain on that mown grass, you know. After you mow your lawn and you put some. You know, if it's a summer rain coming on your lawn, and that you wake up the next day and that lawn is full of life, you know, those blades are thick, green blades in the grass, man, bringing them to life, man. That's what we're compared to, man. Like the rain coming down on mown grass, man. That's the Apah metaphor, man. So let me go back to 2 Samuel. Go in on that. 2 Samuel verse 5. Oops. 23:5. It says, although my house. Well, let me read 4 again so we can read it in context. And he shall be as the light of the morning when the sun riseth, even a morning without clouds, as the tender grass springing out of the earth, clear, shining after the rain. Alright? So that's what King David is likened unto, and the prophet stuff, you know? We're likened unto that morning rain, you know? Bringing life to that grass. And we're bringing life to the one-third, you know, of Israel that listens and believes. So the rest of the house, the two-thirds, let's read about them. Verse 5. Although my house be not so with Yahweh, yet he hath made me with an everlasting covenant. So it shows you right here, man, that his house is not with Yahweh. Not his whole entire house, man. Only one third is going to believe the truth. Only one third is going to be able to leave all their bullshit doctrines behind when the truth is presented to them, you know? When you get this truth presented to you and you can see the actual what it is instead of the lies that Esau Edom taught you. Well, now you see, now you can take yourself out of that equation. You're not that wicked ass part of the house, man, which is the house of Israel. Two thirds, you see, is wicked. And that shows you that Yahweh's not dealing with everybody, because King David's saying it right here, man. And we're going to keep reading because it gets even more meat on this bone. All right, this is 5 again. Although my house be not so with Yahweh, yet he hath made me an everlasting covenant, ordered in all things and sure, for this is all my salvation and all my desire, although he make it not to grow. See? So, you know, this is a metaphor for, yeah, we would like for the whole house of Israel to listen. But then that would make Yahweh a liar. Because he said, well, let's get it. He said 2/3 are going to get cut off and die, man. So if the whole house listened, then that would make that would make Yahweh Bashem Yahshai a liar. And we know he's not a liar. It says, and it shall come to Zechariah 13:8, and it shall come to pass that in all the land, saith Yahweh Bashem Yahshai, two parts therein shall be cut off and die, but the third shall be left therein. And I will bring the third part through the fire, and will refine them as silver is refined, and will try them as gold is tried. They shall call on my name, and I will hear them. I will say, it is my people, and they shall say, Yahweh Bashem Yahshai is my power. Alright? So, hey, the 2/3 is not going to be brought through the fire. It's going to be cut off and die, like we read in verse 8. But the third shall be left therein. That's only 1/3 of the house that's going to listen and hearken. We go back to 2 Samuel 23 and verse 5. I'm going to read it again. It says, although my house be not so with Yahweh, yet he hath made me with me an everlasting covenant, ordered in all things and sure, for this is all my salvation and all my desire, although he make it not grow. See? So King David knew too about the 2/3. Because he's talking about the house is wicked, man. Let's keep reading. Verse 6, but the sons of Belial shall be all of them as thorns thrust away, because they cannot be taken with hands. Alright? So let's look up that word Belial. I looked it up. And this is what it means. Belial is a Hebrew word used to characterize the wicked or worthless. The etymology of the word is often understood as lacking worth from two common words, Beli and Yaal. So it really goes back to Baal. Alright? There's different variations of this word that are really symbolic to wickedness and worshiping the pagan and wicked demonic demon Satan. So 2/3 of our people are just that, right? They're worthless and wicked. And that's what King David, that's why he said in verse 5, the whole house is not with Yahweh. See, let's read it again. Verse 5, although my house be not so with Yahweh, yet he hath made with me an everlasting covenant, ordered in all things and sure. See? So the everlasting covenant is not for the whole entire house of Israel, as we're reading here. And the sons of Belial, hey, those are wicked, worthless people. The 2/3 are wicked and worthless. That's why when we're out there on the highways and the byways teaching, and we come across people that reject our knowledge, reject our truth, reject this doctrine, and we ain't gonna lose no sleep. We're gonna shake the dust off our feet and move on, And just like the elders always say, hey, if a nigga can't get it, we're gonna move the fuck on. You see? We don't have time to debate. We're out here for the elect. We're not out here for the fucking 2/3. You see? I want to read it again. 2 Samuel 23:5. Although my house be not so with Yahweh. See? This is King David talking. What was the house of David? All of the tribes. When King David was the king over Israel, all the tribes were part of Israel. It was not a split kingdom. You didn't have northern and southern kingdom. So he's talking about all the tribes. They all have wickedness in them. 2/3. All right. Let's go back. Let's go get it real quick. Isaiah 1 and 5 maybe. There it is. Why should ye be stricken any more? Ye will revolt more and more. The whole head is sick and the whole heart faint. And what head is sick? The leadership of Israel. Alright, this is talking about Israel. So-called blacks, Latinos, and Native Americans. Alright, just because you're an Israelite doesn't make you righteous. See, when these heathen listen to us teach, they think that we're out there for all of the so-called blacks, Latinos, and Native Americans, and they're dead wrong. We're only out there for the elect. Because we read it earlier, the other ones are Belial. You see, worthless. Alright? Wicked and worthless. Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai cannot use a two-third ass nigga. Someone who's clinging and cleaving to Jesus Christ or Buddha or fucking anything that this fucking Edomite has to offer you in Babylon. You see? They're worthless, man. Belial. You see? The sons of Belial. You ain't part of this. This ain't for you. That's why you reject this truth, man. All we gotta do is read the scriptures. Explains everything. Second Samuel 23:7. But the man that shall touch them must be fenced with iron and the staff of a spear, and they shall be utterly burned with fire in the same place. There it is. You're going to be burned with fire in the same place, man. You two-thirds. You heathen. You sons of Belial, like it said in verse 6. Sons of the wicked. All right, who's the son of the wicked? You so-called blacks and Latinos and Native Americans that want to follow your daddy Esau, and you don't want to follow the truth. You don't want to hearken unto the prophets of the Lord. You're too busy caught up in some bullshit doctrine. That the Lord's closed your eyes. He hasn't lifted the veil off of your blind eyes. And you can't see it. You can't see what we see. You know? Let me go to Hebrews real quick to close out on this precept. Hebrews. Let's go to 6 and 8. But that which beareth thorns and briars is rejected, and is nigh unto cursing, whose end is to be burned. See? You two-thirds are rejected, man. You're rejected from Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. It's not enough to just be an Israelite, man. Or to know you're an Israelite. You know, you still may be a two-third ass nigga, man. And that's all there is to it. If you can't receive this knowledge and this truth, then guess what? You're a two-third. Yahweh didn't give you the ability or the mercy to get this knowledge, to get this wisdom, all right? And we're reading in 2 Samuel 23, you know, and this is the words of King David. He's basically, it says, these were his, you know, last words, you see? But his last words was cursing the two-thirds, man. You see? So that's your pa. Even when King David was, you know, ready to go into the spiritual realm, he was cursing out the two-thirds, man. Basically just saying, hey, this ain't for them. They're rejected. Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai rejects the two-thirds. Alright? So with that, I want to give all praise and glory unto Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai Bashem Rakah Kodash. Double honors goes out to the elder apostles of Great Millstone for teaching me this truth. Also, want to acknowledge all the Akyam for pushing this truth with sincerity. Shalom to the elect.